first century program for two major reasons. One is I'm fascinated with technology and the possibilities of how I can do things differently in the classroom. It seems to satisfy some creative urge that I have to try and do things differently. And I love art, visual aspects, and kinesthetic aspects. And I find technology a challenge. So I'm always up for the challenge of working with it. And the second major reason is that Jen Cody, who does this program for the high school, did a small demonstration to our professional learning committee for language arts because she had used one at her old high school. And when she showed, it was the first time I'd seen a smart board demonstration, and when she showed how you could edit work on a smart board, that just amazed me. And I knew I had to have one because that could change the way that I teach writing in the classroom.
You hear so much about technology in the classroom, but I want to be able to use it and have the kids using the technology as opposed to just me learning technology. I saw what a major learning curve it was for me to pick up some of the technology, because that's not how I was taught at school. It wasn't a lot of integration of technology. So when I saw the opportunity for the 21st century classroom to acquire some of that equipment to be able to use in the classroom, I thought it would be a great way, not only for me to learn, but again, my focus really opened on it, what I wanted to do, was have the kids learn, have them using the equipment, not just me using the equipment. So I thought it would be another tool into my teaching toolbox.
Today, everything is done online. Everything is done through a computer or an iPod or some form of technology. Everything moves very fast and so forth. And so the kids need to be able to interact the way that people are now doing so, whether it's through email. Most people want to be contacted through email instead of phone now. Most people have all of their information on their BlackBerry or this or that, and the kids need to be able to know how to use this technology and use it well and to their advantage, not just simply for instant messaging at home with their friends. And although you may think that most of the kids already have all this technology at home, there are the select few that come in here and say, oh, I don't have that, or I've never been on this, I've never used that. And for that purpose, using this equipment, it brings something to them that they don't have at home to use.
I will have to say it is my document camera. I love it. It's allowed me to access a lot of materials that I had, but they're books that I'd get and I'd see a really great idea, but you didn't necessarily want to photocopy the whole page for 100 kids, and it might just have been a piece of something. I didn't need the whole piece. So I have journals or warm-ups, as some teachers call them, when the kids come in. I have typed up a lot of them that I already had, and so they're and available, which is nice. But a lot of books have really great visual, with the geometry or with measurement. You don't just have the text. And to create that would either, photocopy to go to an overhead transparency, which means then you got to get the overhead. So this allows me just instantly to put the book or the small piece. It allows you to zoom in on just a part of the book and use the camera for that.
There's a lot needed that we have traditionally not done in the area of formative assessment. And having the Centio clickers, it enables me to pose a lot of questions that are more formative, gives me a picture of each student on a lot of the fundamentals. And a lot of the physics education research shows that the best way to improve long-term understanding of concepts and create more Newtonian thinkers is you need to have an interactive dialogue. And by the immediate feedback from the Centio program, displaying pie charts showing what some students are selecting for answers, how many people are getting each answer correct, whether you have a large misconception or not, provides a foundation for very, very precise, targeted, interactive dialogue.
Students are much more engaged. They're paying attention during notes because Centio clickers are used to test how well they've been paying attention over the course of the note section in class, and they are very enthusiastic about using them as well. they ask to use them. They're really excited about using them and want to use them all the time.
Every teacher in my professional learning group on the content, the language arts content, has asked. One of the sixth grade teachers also has a smart board. So we get really excited about some of the things that we can do with a smart board. So we get caught up. The meetings are held in my room, so we often get caught up in doing demonstrations of what we can do. So all language arts teachers, all of the members of my interdisciplinary seventh grade academic team know what's going on, because two of us on the team, a math teacher, Sheila Wells, and myself, also have them. Everyone around me physically knows what's going on. They've either popped in my room and seen what's happening, or I've pulled them in to show them, and they all want one. So I've asked them to apply for next year, because hopefully the program will go on.
Students actually say it's fun to take quizzes, and they have requested quizzes on the Sentio clickers, if you will. And I can remember one of the first times we were doing it, one of my students who is not generally that concerned with his academics said, oh, this is actually really fun.
My wife is also a teacher, and I brought the equipment home actually to practice and to present lessons, and she's shown some curiosity and interest about it, you know, how it works and what I'm using it for and how it really impacted my classroom. I'm taking a class at USM, and one of the things that I'm going to be doing is taking that equipment and kind of using it in a presentation I'm doing in my class at USM. So that's going to be actually this afternoon, so I'm sure people will have questions about that.
The virtual world experience was pretty great, because it was something brand new for myself, something brand new for them, and they were really helpful and great in trying something new and, you know, giving me feedback on what they thought. My first class just finished the virtual world experience yesterday, and I got reflection forms from them, and a lot of them said it was some of the most engaging work that they've done in an English class thus far.
It's great to take student work and be able to show lots of strategies or approaches to the same type of problem, which is really one of the IB criterion, is to be able to look at what you did and then think about an alternative method, which is hard for seventh graders to think that way. You know, they think once they get a right answer, that's good enough. But we, instead of taking all the time to have the kids go up, which they still love to do, go up to the board and write their answer, but it takes a lot of class time and we don't always have that. They can bring their paper up and we can show three or four different methods really quickly.
I think when you're looking at integrating the technology, every teacher, when you ask the biggest challenges, probably most of them are going to say time, and time is an issue. But I think bigger than that is there are certain aspects you want to have for quality instruction. And the backwards design model is an effective model. There's a lot of attributes that go into a well-organized lesson. And then you don't just want to do technology for technology's sake, you want to use technology for part of an effective lesson. So making sure that all of those things are blending properly is part of this challenge. It takes a very focused effort. Mm-hmm.